Hey guys, it's Jeff Lapperty, and time for another art cast. This one is number 33. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing? It's probably Monday for most of you guys. I had a lot of stuff to talk about, and I can't think of one thing. It's like super hot here today. So, I don't know how long I'm going to make this video, because I had to turn my fan off. And I already feel like getting cooked again, so I might just cut this one short and turn my fan back on. Because it is super hot today. I don't know what happened. It was pretty cool last night. And I opened up the front window and put the fan in it, and the back windows of my studio, and had all the air coming in, and it was pretty cool in here. And boy, when I woke up, I was like, gosh, it's so hot. It's like I didn't even do that. So I guess it's getting towards that time of the year, though. We had one day where it was, I'm sure you guys tuned in to hear the weather update for Boulder, but we had one day where it was kind of nice and cooler, but then yesterday was super hot again. Yesterday I had to go and help my dad haul some hay. I have to do that once a month. It goes to this hay auction, and so I got cooked out there doing that. Very tiring. I'm getting old, I think, and notice every time I go and do that, I feel hurt in some way. I think I hurt my elbow. Not that I'm complaining, but it's just, I don't know. All that physical activity, even though, you know, I'm pretty used to having a physical job, it seems like doing that, hauling hay is just very strenuous work. And it's crazy. It's like I have a hard time keeping up with my dad, really. He's like, over 60 years old, and had a heart attack last year, and he's still freaking work harder than me, it seems like. So, but anyway, so what's going on with me beyond that kind of stuff? I guess that is what's going on with me. This is a piece I started last night and didn't quite get finished. And so just getting it done today, another one of the Daenerys. I don't know that I'm in such a Game of Thrones kick. I don't know. I saw this picture, really kind of caught my eye, and I liked her shadows on her face. She's actually kind of hard to draw because she's such a light-skinned girl, and she doesn't have a lot of stuff to draw, you know? Like when you're doing portraits, it's easier to draw the, you know, wrinkly guy than it is like the perfect, opulent, you know, beautiful girl, because the wrinkly guy has all the wrinkles and stuff. He has stuff to draw, you know. And you know, the girl just doesn't, there's nothing to draw, nothing to kind of hang the shape on sometimes. But this picture kind of had it, and it kind of matches up with the turret Tyrion, the dwarf guy from Game of Thrones. This piece is kind of the same, because, you know, central figure, and in that one there was a couple guards in the back, and in this one, you know, she's standing in front of her army, and it's a nice kind of composition. I liked it. I don't know if you can see the whole thing. There it is. And just wanted to draw it. I've been kind of going through a little. I mean, I actually have been kind of going through a little bit of a, I wouldn't say artist block, but maybe thinking about stuff that's not helping me in a way, you know. I was on, I think I mentioned that in last video, Marshall Coulter's podcast, Escape Pod, or no, Escape Artist. That's another one I listen to, is Escape Pod. It's like fiction. And I kind of like, I like listening to fiction stuff sometimes. The thing about that is it's so hit or miss. I have a hard time. I don't really have many friends that read. My wife reads, but she reads not really the same kind of stuff I like. She reads a lot of kind of Dean Koontz and that kind of stuff, thriller stuff. But I don't know. I like to listen to fantasy type stuff, I guess. I don't know. It's hard to say. And I don't really have that many people that I know that can kind of recommend books, so it's like when I listen to some of this fiction, I usually end up listening to just stuff I already know. Like Edgar Rice Burroughs, you know, John Carter stuff, older stuff, you know, the Robert E. Howard stuff. What was I talking about? Oh, being in kind of a funk, and it's more of one, which I know this can be, I think actually what happened was, you know, being on Marshall's show, and he talked a little bit about getting out of kind of your own way, and how do you get past sort of the negative self-talk and being overly critical of yourself, and I'm not immune to that, but it's something I used to have probably pretty bad, and I don't have it as much anymore. You know, I'm more like, I kind of see it for what it is. I don't know if you guys listen to the show, but on there I kind of said, you know, I can kind of recognize it as being like, that's not reality. That's just kind of stuff that I'm doing to myself right now. Boy, is it hot in here. It's just getting sweltering. But that, and then he also asked me at the end about kind of what my plans were. And boy, that was such a hard question to answer. Because it's like, you know, my plans are to continue to draw exactly what I'm drawing now. And I think I gave a good answer, because I said I wanted to, like, just go in the direction I'm going and just see, you know, like, kind of almost let my audience sort of tell me where to go, you know, show me what they want painted, and I would just kind of keep going in that direction, because I didn't want to, because like always in my career I've always been kind of like, you know, wanting to do a comic or something, and all that stuff just never works out, and I think it's actually hurt my career. So I kind of wanted to like approach it from a different stand or different kind of viewpoint, and be more like, you know, I want to draw what people want and build a career on that kind of a thing. But I mean, more than that, you know, like the answer was, you know, it was like immediate plans. It's just to continue to sell, continue to get commissions, continue to build the audience so that my prices go up, and just continue to build everything that I've built so far, and that it's working so far, you know. And man, I had a hard time saying that, because it just sounds so like, you know, like, yeah, you're gonna like just basically make a career selling art on eBay, good luck, you know what I mean? That's the thing that's in my head. But it's like, yeah, that is what I'm doing, and that's what's working, you know. And but it was really hard for me to think that, because, you know, that's not a career for any kind of self-respecting artist, you know. I've been on forums like where people are talking about selling on eBay and stuff, you know, and inevitably you'll get a few people having a conversation about that, and then you'll have a guy come screaming in there from who knows where, and their opinion of eBay or selling art online even will be like, oh, eBay's just an online flea market. I wouldn't, you know, stoop to, you know. Or like they'll see the kind of prices people are getting on eBay, and they'll be like, that's not. I mean, what's one guy I remember was like saying that it's not even grown up money, you know. And it's just like, oh my God, it's just such a hard thing to hear and take. And you know, the thing is it might not be, because it's like in different parts of the country and different lifestyles, you know. I couldn't, you know, live in San Francisco off of what I make, or New York or something. But living in Colorado, I can, you know. And so it's all kind of a relevant thing, and also it's relevant to your lifestyle. I'm not a guy who buys new cars and you know, houses and all this kind of stuff. I don't need to have a boat so I can go water skiing and you know, whatever else, you know. I live a very simple life, and that's how I like it. I like being not being in debt, you know. I got into debt when I was younger, and I said never again, and I've basically done that. I don't know. It's a lot of that's perspective on like what you're making, for sure. But where was I going with all this? All that stuff kind of weighs in my mind sometimes, you know. It's and it's not a healthy kind of self-talk to have. Because, you know, if you look at it realistically, this is almost like, this is why it's kind of nice to do a podcast, because it's kind of funny. It's like I'm working through it right here, you know, as I think about it. But it's, you know, you don't want to be telling yourself, you know, like you want to look at it for what it is, not for what, you know, your brain is kind of like obsessing over or freaking out over. You know what I mean? And the thing that it is right now is that it is money. It's the same kind of money that I make when I go to paint a house. You know what I mean? And the reality is it does come in, you know, and pay the bills just like the other jobs, so that it is grown-up money, you know. And that's the kind of thing I've got to kind of keep telling myself and keep... you know, I can't let that kind of nonsense get in the way. Because it's like when he asked the question, and not saying anything against the guy, I really appreciate being on the show. I'm just kind of like talking about some stuff that happened to me afterwards or what I've been thinking about. But like when he asked the question, it was almost like I felt like I should be giving an answer like, okay, I'm going to, you know, continue to draw the stuff, and then hopefully somebody, you know, online or, you know, some editor is going to, like, see my stuff, and then I'll get hired to do book covers, and then, you know what I mean? It was like, it was almost like I wanted to give that kind of, like, answer that, you know, everybody kind of gives, or the way everybody is supposed to be looking at art, you know, like when somebody's a young artist and they go to art school and they... You know, they plan that this is going to be my career, and I just have to get noticed, I have to get my big break, and, you know. And that's absolutely not what I'm planning, you know. Okay, sorry, I actually had to turn the camera off for a bit there, because that dang update thing happened again on my computer. I hope I didn't mess up the beginning of this video. That's how I lost those the beginnings of those other videos. For some reason, my computer wants to update, and it just wipes the video that if I'm recording while that's happening, it just gets rid of the beginning of it, which is a real pain in the neck, because then I have a show that starts in the middle, and you guys don't even have a clue what the heck I'm talking about. So. Yeah, I don't know. I've been I was just kind of like talking about, you know, just, you know, keeping that positive attitude. I guess that's kind of what it boils down to. And keep kind of going in the direction that you want to go. I should have talked about this in the very beginning of the show, but I think I'm going to. Man, I actually had a bunch of topics that I was going to talk about. Now that reminds me of something else I should have talked about. But maybe I'll just kind of hold back on some of that stuff. But one thing I wanted to... I was thinking about doing... I was talking... I joined like this one group on Facebook. It's not a very good group, I don't think. Peter Palmiotti, the awesome Peter Palmiotti. I'm always referencing in my videos. I think I reference Peter as much as, like, Darren Biedman references me in his videos. Like, every video I talk about Peter, and in every video I notice that I show up in Darren's videos. Yeah, I'm just playing with you, Darren, if you're watching or listening or whatever. You know I love you, dude, and I think your videos are great, so keep going. I'm watching them. Anyway, Peter hooked me up with a link to this Patreon group where there's a bunch of guys on there talking about Patreon, which is really cool. I didn't even think to look for something like that. That was a good find there. And I joined and put my link in and talked a little bit and left the notifications on, which a lot of times when I join these groups, I actually have to turn them off because it's just like way too much extra junk in my email box, which I already have a hard time with managing my emails. But the group is, you know, I mean, it's really a bunch of people that I don't really think, I hope I don't insult anybody right now, but basically the group is, at least who's talking in the group right now, is kind of like quite a few people who I don't really think have any more idea about Patreon than I do, and I think probably even less. Like, a lot of them are just like, you know, you kind of read what they're saying and look at their thing and you go like, well, God, of course that's not going to work, you know. But there's one guy that jumped in there named Chris. Is his name Chris Perillo? He's kind of a, you know, internet celebrity kind of guy, you know. He's done these tech shows. You know, he's like a tech blogger, I think. I've run onto him quite a few times in the last, you know, 5 or 6 years of being online. And I think the way he made money was he'd do like a live stream kind of show. And he probably still does it, I don't know. And he would review, you know, X product, whatever it may be, and then work the affiliate angle on that. So, like, you know, he would have affiliate links to his stuff, you know what I mean? Like, whatever he's talking about. Like, let's say he's talking about GoPro cameras, because I'm thinking about buying a GoPro.
I hate when that thing happens. It always happens with these Prismacolors. They're so soft. But the Prismacolors are the only kind of white I can really use on this stuff, because it's soft, so it's also bright. But anyway, that's kind of how he made his name doing those, and I think that he's done them so long that he's built like this massive following, and he's, you know, a really clever guy about marketing. And I went and I looked. I hadn't seen that he was on Patreon, but I went and looked, and I think he's like getting like $7,000 a month off that thing, just off Patreon. So I think he was pretty successful anyway with just his normal show and stuff, but when I saw that, I was like, wow, that's pretty incredible. And I talked to him a little bit just in the forum there, and was just, you know, asking him like some tips, if he had any, for, like, you know, us, because I didn't really think anybody else in this Patreon, this is like the Patreon podcast now, I realize. I think for 3 shows I've talked about Patreon. Well, sorry if you guys are getting tired of it, but I just asked him some stuff, and I kind of looked at what he was doing, and he kind of inspired me a little bit, because I think I was sort of writing the Patreon off a little bit. Like, the last couple shows, I just bitched about Patreon pretty much, and I don't know that I should necessarily be writing it off so quickly, you know, because I think it's going to be there. It's going to be there, you know, in a year or two, and it's just going to do what it's going to do. So if it can do better, then I should try to make it do better, you know. But one idea, anyway, from talking to this other guy, Chris, he didn't give me the idea, but he just kind of gave me some general, you know, advice about, you know, crowdfunding or building an audience or whatnot. But I was thinking, like, perhaps to do a giveaway kind of thing, where I do a drawing like these ones, just like Denarius here, or Denarius, and I'll do one. I don't know if it'll be an every month thing, but it's going to be just this month for now. And I thought I'd put it at like as one of the goals, because I don't really have any goals in there. And I thought I'd say, you know, hey, if we can get up to like $100 a month, then or $100 a week actually per update, then I'd do a giveaway. I'd do one of these drawings at the end of the month, and then draw a name out of the hat of all the Patreon supporters, and give it away. And I think that's kind of cool, because I did that one time before, a long time ago, and I did it sort of for Facebook shares. This was like a time when I did this one. I had done that Mad Max sketch card, which I don't know if you guys know it. It's on my site. And for some reason, I couldn't sell the pencil study. It just kind of sat there in my store for like, you know, a month. The painting went right away, but the pencil study just... That was back when I did pencil studies of every painting. Now I just actually just do the painting, and I just do drawings of other stuff. But anyway, I just sat there in my store forever. I couldn't sell it, and I thought, well, this might be a way to kind of up my audience a little bit on YouTube. And I was doing videos. This was like when I was actually just off work. I was laid off during the winter, and I needed some money, and so I just thought, oh, let's try this. And so I put that one up. I was like, you know, everybody who shares my work can enter into this contest, and and then I'll draw a name out of the hat. And I had a lot of shares. It didn't really work as well as I thought, because I realized that a lot of my audience doesn't have much of an audience of their own, you know. So I get shares to basically, you know, nobody really liking it or you know what I mean, seeing it. But it was fun, though, and it was kind of cool. And I drew a name at the end of the month and sent the guy the drawing. But the thing was, is it was kind of like, I don't know, I kind of felt like that was a sort of a drag, because I just gave it to a random person who never has bought anything from me, has never really, you know, done anything really, other than just maybe do a Facebook share, you know. And that's fine, but I want to give back to the people who are like trying to support me, who are like, hey, Jeff, I want you to make it, and here's a few bucks to make it, you know. So I thought this might be a better idea, because, you know, Patreon's a super cheap way to do that. You can easily just, you know, get in there and just give me, like, the minimum pledge is a dollar per week. So for $4 a month, you can enter into a contest to win one of my drawings. And I don't think I'm going to do it as a commission, because then... I don't know. Inevitably, what happens when you do that is it's like, okay, you know, here's your commission, and what do you want me to draw? And then they immediately go, okay, I want you to draw, you know, like Wonder Woman jumping out of a plane, and there's going to be a plane with a gorilla jumping out behind that, and can you, you know, somehow get Brad Pitt in there? And you know what I mean? It's just like, they just, it's almost like the buffet platter of like every fucking thing you can fit into a square inch of a piece. I don't want to do that, but I thought we could all maybe vote or something towards the end of the month of like what I should draw, and then I'll draw one and do a video at the same time, and also draw the name out of the hat, which that'll be fun. So I probably didn't explain that well, but I can kind of clarify it as I get it more more pinned down in my own mind. But so yeah, I think for this month, for what is it, July now? So July, I'm gonna do at the end of the month, I'm gonna give away a drawing. And I guess, you know, I don't know how many of you Patreon guys are actually watching this video, but We should, how should I do that? Maybe I should... I'm just trying to think how we should decide, like, what I should draw. We should like, all kind of throw in some ideas, and maybe I'll draw a name out of the hat for that, too, you know? And I think that would be kind of cool, because then it's also, like, I can include all the dollar guys, too, who I never send anything to. You know, because it's like a dollar just gets your name in the videos, and that's pretty much it. So, sometimes I feel like I neglect those guys, but then I guess they're not giving as much either as the guys who get the print, so. But I got everybody's print requests except for two people, and I don't know if you guys, the ones that haven't emailed me yet, if you get a chance to, that'd be awesome. But other than that, I'll just send you guys, I'll just pick you a new print or a new couple prints out of the ones I've done, and I'll just send them. So I want to get those things out of here probably on Tuesday or Wednesday of this week. So, because I definitely have a tendency to build up packages, and the Patreon thing, since it's not like with eBay, you know, I want to get stuff out immediately. But with Patreon, since you're kind of sitting around with stuff that's going to, you know, I don't know, more random people, and then it's like also there's no deadline, and sometimes I'm waiting to hear from people. They have a tendency to sit around here for a little longer, and I want to get it more so that, you know, maybe like on the 5th that everybody's got to tell me what to do, and on the 10th everything goes out, you know. Be more like bam, bam, bam every month, so that people can really count on getting their prints and stuff. So, anyway, is that a good show? I think that's a pretty decent show. I was gonna, I guess I did kind of talk more about the confidence crisis and stuff. I noticed one other thing I'm gonna throw in here, because I wanted to talk a little more about it, but probably don't really have time. But, you know, I have. A lot of people, actually, hang on, I gotta get some white paint. Actually, before I go into any of that, whoops, hang on, the brush is just, yeah, it's like the end of the week, even though it's the beginning of the next week, and I need a new brush. This one is just biting it. Should probably buy nicer brushes, this wouldn't happen, but. Just so convenient to grab one of these new ones, and then it feels so good when it's new. Probably should just buy two of them every week. Yeah, before I talk about that, the other thing, I was thinking too with the people on Patreon. I mean, what is like? I mean, I know Sofera has been really helpful at like kind of telling me stuff about Patreon, and it's really helped. Me kind of view it as a, you know, from the outside in kind of thing. Because it's hard when you're making stuff up in your mind about, like, what people want as pledges and things like that. I mean, I originally envisioned Patreon as just kind of like a subscription kind of thing to my prints, because I had people buying prints every month consistently, and a lot of those people are still doing it. But they didn't bother to join Patreon, which is fine, but I kind of thought those would be the people that join, and those totally weren't. They just want to buy their prints when they want to buy them, and so I kind of geared the Patreon like pledges and stuff towards prints, thinking that that's what people wanted. But what is it like that you guys on there do want, you know what I mean? I've had people, lots of people tell me, you know, art lesson kind of things, but I think that's way too specific to like the person who makes the comment. I don't know. I don't want to talk about like that right now, because it's like I think eventually I'll probably get some kind of how to draw a book kind of thing going or something. But, I mean, for the time being, I was like, I ain't got time for that. But you know, if that is something that is interesting people, I mean, what would what is like the thing that you know you guys want out of me? Is it more just the content that you're getting from the videos, or yeah, it's just very kind of perplexing. And even like this kind of giveaway, original art giveaway kind of thing, that's just like one more kind of example of something that I kind of thought up in my head that you guys probably would want. I don't know that you guys want that, you know, because I know that there's a ton of people watching me on YouTube that aren't buying off eBay, you know. So that seems to be like just like a whole nother kind of subset of people that are interested in something other than the originals, you know. I don't know. I'd love to, you know, get some feedback if you guys have time to just throw a comment in, or even if you don't want to say something in front of everybody, you could just email it to me. My email's on my website. JeffLafferty.net is my website, by the way. And there's that. The other thing I was going to say was, you know, a lot of people have kind of jumped on, you know, on this idea of like selling stuff, and they've emailed me and kind of like, oh, I want to do what you're doing, and I do this thing, and then they kind of keep me updated on what's going on, and a lot of them now have like got onto eBay or whatever it is, and have kind of emailed me, you know, their auctions and stuff, and I've tried to share the ones that that I can, but I've also kind of went and looked at some of these guys. I'm not talking about anybody specific, so whoever's thinking I'm talking about them, please don't, because there's more than one. There's actually quite a few, and you know, some of them have gone on to eBay, and it hasn't worked. You know what I mean? I can see that they posted a few auctions, some of them quite a few, and they're not getting bids and stuff. You know what I mean? And I just wanted to throw out like one more kind of thing, like for the people like I've inspired to do that with or whatever, and that's to that like. The obvious next step to that, you know, it's like you put up your eBay auctions and, you know, kind of told me about them, and I'm sure you kind of hoped that would bring in some of my audience to buy your cards or whatever, and it might have happened for some of you guys, but you know, you gotta think too, it's just, you know, they're like my audience, they're into my work, so they might not necessarily be into your work, but you know, like at this point when it's maybe not working or you're feeling like it's not gonna work, you know, it's like the next step is to basically go get people that are gonna buy stuff off, buy your stuff, you know what I mean? Go looking for those guys. And like I said, I mean it's the same thing as with me, you know. As you post more stuff, more people kind of follow you on eBay. As you sell more stuff, more people, every time you sell one, that person's probably going to check back in, or possibly check back in, or maybe get on your mailing list, or follow you on Facebook, or whatever it is. All those people are going to be easier to buy, to sell to, than like the people that you're going out and hunting. You know what I mean? That sounded horrible, but like the people you're hunting around to find, that's going to be a fan of your work. But it's like, you know, don't just think that like, oh, well, it didn't sell on eBay. It's not going to work. It only works for him. Don't give up there. You know what I mean? Get a, you know, just get a whatever piece of paper or open up a Word document or something and start writing down ideas of where you're going to find people that might end up at your auctions, and that's the next step. You know what I mean? And I'm just saying that because I want to encourage the people that are taking a leap to continue going. Don't just sort of like go, you know, don't just give up in a way, you know what I mean? And so, I don't know, I hope that helps somebody. On the other hand, I've also noticed some guys who are kind of did the same thing. You know, emailed me early on and were like, you know, I want to do that and stuff like that. And at least one guy in specifically that I can think of, all of a sudden now I'm just seeing him do all these commissions, you know. And that's the same thing, you know. He's making it work. And so like that, I'm like super happy that it's happening. But I want it to happen for everybody, you know. I want all you guys to like sell your work and make all kinds of money and side money or livings or whatever the heck it is. So I'm rooting for everybody, and that's kind of why I said that. I'm not trying to get down on anybody. I'm just saying that, you know, don't let that first roadblock stop you. You know, it sucks, and you know, it's a bummer, and you can feel bad about it for a while, but then, you know, get up and freaking figure out the next step, which is basically getting people to those auctions. That's what's going to sell your work. So how can you get more people to those auctions, you know? Can you get 3 people? Can you get 5? Can you get 20? Can you get 100? 300? Serious, dude. My auctions used to be, I'd get freaking 15 people to an auction, and that was like a job to get those many people to it. And, you know, I noticed like that Indiana Jones piece that's up right now, that freaking auction, I haven't even really promoted it, and it's got like 200 and something hits on it. I mean, if I could have like even foreseen that like back then, I would have been like, oh, I'm getting nowhere. But it's definitely possible. And also, when I first started doing the videos, and I was kind of like, I'm going to do this on the side, you know, this was all back few months ago, kind of like back when I was doing like the Blade Runner pieces and stuff like that. I was actively pushing as much traffic to those auctions as I could find, and I had more time to do that than I do now, because now it's kind of like once I get one piece done, I need to start another one, and that's another key to it, you know. Once one person buys one thing, it's like give them another thing to buy. But anyway, back kind of with those Blade Runner pieces, the Conan pieces, you know, just by going around to Facebook groups and DeviantArt and things like that, I was able to, you know, some of those auctions would hit like 600 people, and it's I don't know, I look at it now as like they're up high, but you know, I mean, really and truly, I'm not even satisfied with you know, 200-300 people. I want like, you know, 1,000 people showing up. So, even myself, I'm still working to, you know, increase the traffic and find that next guy that's gonna, you know, love this piece and want it on his wall. So, anyway, I'm gonna like end this video and turn my fan back on, because it is so hot here. Definitely a guy. I used to love summer so much as a kid, and I loved going swimming and all the stuff you could do in summer, and I think I loved just being out of school the most. I never liked going to school, and summer was just my time, you know. And it's funny, it's like now that I've gotten older, and I really like the winter, actually. We're not the dead cold, the coldest part of the winter, but just, you know, like everything outside of like that January, February type months, I just like, I like the cool weather. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and this one will be up on eBay if you want to check it out. Check out my Patreon if you want to support me or enter to win a drawing. I haven't figured out what it'll be, but at the end of the month, I'll, you know, draw a name out of the hat and give away a drawing. And I'll probably mention that in every video till then. So Thanks, guys, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.